There is another somewhat discomfiting scenario today, and that is the fact that while there has been a string of cabinet-level visits to my part of the world, Southeast Asia, and indeed the president himself will be making a trip next month, what is absent is the very active engagement by sub-cabinet officials that we saw during the Obama administration, which is quite absent today. And that makes it very difficult for us to have any sort of substantive follow-up on the grand statements by the James Mattis or by Tillerson or by indeed by the president himself.
I think a lot of predicaments that were discussed today have to do with short-termism of policy, with the electoral cycle, and with the need for politicians to keep in mind this very intense, very short-term waves, like, you know, surfers who have to take the latest wave if disgruntled voters worry for jobs or worry about migration. They have to address that, and that brings huge swings in policies, and we cannot talk about strategies anymore.
Asian societies with their models, I think that they would be well advised not to gloat, because I think every model has to be suited to their particular context. Likewise, every model will have their weak spots, and the trick for governance is to identify and to deal with those weak spots before they become big problems.
But I think this question about technology and democracy was very interesting, because sort of technology has, in the past 2 decades, been a lot about entertainment. And I think we are moving more and more to the paradigm in which technology serves a broader societal good. So it will be very apparent in education and health.